studies in America. The three main causes that inflected economic boom were the global and domestic demand in consumerism. Secondly, the scarcity of food during the World War II when there was some US rationing in wartime. And this means that each person have a limited proportion amount of food. And lastly, the massive spending on tactics and defense. So these are the consequences. The first one was the increase in demand in cars, houses and televisions as people rushed to buy new goods. And this led to improved roads as well as higher incomes. And the third one was that the people migrated from the rural areas into the urban areas. And lastly, there was some highway system that they built in order to aid military support and therefore enhance commerce and mobility. There were also negative consequences. Like the urban problems, once people migrated into the city, there was a hub of drug abuse and crime rate increase as well. Also, as industrial increase, there was also pollution. Other than that, the two main events, Communist China and Korean War, caused the Red Scare. The Red Scare is basically like a propaganda that tried to avoid any sort of communism in America. Other than Red Scare, this guy named Joseph McCarthy actually created a campaign called McCarthyism in which to avoid any communist or suspected communist from spreading in America. American Civil Rights Movement. So there are the three main influences, which are Dr. Martin Luther King, Gandhi, and President Lyndon Johnson. So I will be talking individually in the next slide. So firstly is Dr. Martin Luther King. He was the leader of civil rights movement, in which it's a campaign for racial equality, specifically helping and supporting all the African Americans in the US. Before the civil rights movement, there was some segregation of the African Americans, in which the African Americans were treated unequally. Here are some examples of how they were treated unequally. The first one, that there wasn't any sort of like suffrage or voting rights for the African Americans. The second one is that they have limited or poor education. And the third one is that they were discriminated in public services. Last but not least, even they had to like separate restrooms, so they cannot use the same restrooms as the white society. So the next leader is Gandhi. Gandhi was the Indian leader who embraced Indian pride. He was able to fight against the British rule. His tactics were non-violent though, as he did some protest marches, as well as like civil disobedience. And this successfully led to the Indian independence in India. When before that, India was colonized by British, but now they were free from it, just from this guy, Gandhi. So after this actually inspired many civil rights movement. And lastly is President Lyndon Johnson. He was the African president that differentiated from the previous president because he actually supported the African Americans. He created this two acts, which were the Civil Rights Act and the Voting Rights Act. So the divisions in American society, the two main causes that gave a burden on Cold War were the Vietnam War and the racial and ethnic tensions. And after the World War II ended, there was a baby boom era, which led to civil rights protests and anti-war protests by young rebels. So what actually sparked the baby boom? Well, many historians assume that the baby boomers happened just exactly 9 months after the World War II ended. This is because that many soldiers returning back from war to their homes, they decided to like